Involved in writing and performing my poetry at a very young age. I come from a family of storytellers. My mother's an incredible storyteller and would put me to bed with all these stories of growing up in the Dominican Republic. My grandfather only had a third grade education, but would tell these long, complicated riddles for like 30 minutes. And my father loves telling jokes, and they always had these amazing punchlines. They were never dad jokes, they're way inappropriate. But I grew up listening to this oral history, and so my storytelling, and probably the reason I perform, is because I come from folks who pass down all these lessons and these jokes and these histories via this art form. Well, I think a lot about Trujillo and the dictatorship of Trujillo. He killed over, 10 to 20,000 Haitians on the border, and the kinds of ramifications of that anti-blackness, anti-Haitianism. So a lot of my work is thinking through, what was that effect? I think a lot about colonialism, right? The Dominican Republic was the first place where there was a settlement by Spain. And so what is that rupture of native culture, of the Spanish, of the Africans that were brought in? And so a lot of that comes through in my work. And I write a lot about being from New York City and rats and the hood and like the bodegas that I love. I think one of the most important ideas that I would like young people to take away from my poetry is that what you have to say matters, that your story matters, and that even if you don't see yourself in your community or in the world or in this country represented in the way you know you can be, that is when you most need to speak out, and that is when you most have to say, I'm here, and I'm necessary, and I have something to say.